How can I help you guys?
We're looking for someone.
Johnny. His name is Johnny.
Yeah, he's someone 6'4".
No, he's not. 6'5".
At that time, I was a young solo mum, and there's always been this feeling of a negative perception from society towards young brown mums, and so I really wanted to create a show where young brown mothers felt empowered, valid in their choices to have children young, and that they felt capable that they could actually live their dreams and be their own people and still be amazing mums.
Listen here, Beth, okay, I'm not your friend, okay?
Every character carries the weight of their own social message. Mm. You know, Sophia is the afakasi conversation. Kōwhai is the negative perceptions of solo parents.
We relate to it in so many ways. Like Malia, most of her story is exactly like my story. Come from, you know, a family who was strict, raised with like a lot of pride, culture and stuff, and God in it. And it's just sad nowadays to see some of our islander mothers that are hiding because of, you know, that not shame within the family or the family name. And
and it always falls back on the female rather than the male, and that's quite important for us to highlight, like, these girls are so important and it's 2 to 10.
Do you reckon you could actually do Bella's homework with her? It's just, you know, I don't want to watch a Game of Thrones.
What I've learned is that you can definitely chase your dreams even if you're a mother. Some people would be like, I can't chase my dreams because I've got a baby. No.
Yeah.
These guys are like heavily pregnant and directing and acting and stuff, and that just is so inspiring. And
you're
just
like breastfeeding on set.
There was one thing, just that they're proud that, you know, it's the first time we've had our women on screen as leads, and we shouldn't be the last, and we don't want to be the only ones. We want all of the young filmmakers to come out here and start putting our women on screens more. We want our Pacifica and our Indigenous women to start writing and directing more.
And we've got so many stories to tell, and I think, you know, very unique stories that a lot of people don't know, so we're really opening doors for the next generation.
We need more behind and in front of the camera so that mainstream starts to really understand our people and the expectations that society put on us that are just so unfair.